In this episode of IGH Outdoors, a friend of mine, Corey Hagerman, which lives in northern Indiana, actually about 5 miles away from Michigan, came down to where I live. Of course, I live south central Indiana, which was a good long haul for him. I think like 3 hours and 20-minute drive. He came down and was showing me a new design on a sluice mat that he makes for prospecting. Now, we have ran a couple of his other designs before in my regular YouTube channel, it just under my name, Dennis Dayton. But he's got this new design, which I told him, you know, some changes I thought he needed to make to it, which his other mat run worked pretty good. And I'm pretty sure this one's going to work a little bit better. But he has a 3D printer, and he made the mat, you know, like a hard plastic, and then he took that and made a mold. And he made a mold which he could pour three mats. So he came down for the weekend and got the very first mat made, which he made it in my favorite color, which I like in a gold pan, which was purple. And got the very first mat poured. I was pretty impressed. So we did some other things on the weekend, which that'll be in another video. But we got this one done. It's pretty cool how this works and the steps you go through to actually make this. It's like a rubber mat. It's pretty cool. So anyway, with that being said, here we go with Corey Hagerman and making his new mats. This is for the new vlog channel on IGH Outdoors. In this episode, we got Corey Hagerman down here, which is going to be doing what? What are you doing?
Pouring one of my first mats.
So
production mats.
We're going to be getting, what exactly do you have? What is this stuff here?
This is a urethane rubber.
Okay.
Essentially liquid, and then once you mix the two parts together, you got a certain amount of time to get them in whatever it is you're trying to put them in, and then they start to harden up.
Huh. So once you open it up, you break the seal, you're on a time limit basically.
Well, as far as separate, yeah.
Once you get them together, you're on a time limit.
Yep. With this one, you've got 4 minutes.
Which one?
With combining these, you got 4 minutes worth of time to get them mixed and get them in your mold.
And you've got, those are what you're going to mix it in, right?
Yep.
Those containers there?
Yep.
And then you've got that. You got, now what is everything else you got? You got the UV.
Yep. This is the colorant. So UV, this will be turning them purple.
Oh, yeah.
And it has UVO, it's called UVO because it has sun protection in it.
Okay.
So the mats will automatically be UV protected.
And you have the brush to brush it in, I take it. Yep. Your stir sticks. Oh, your, what's that can there?
This here's a mold release.
Okay.
It's what you put in your mold to help aid getting the material back out of the mold after it cures.
Your gloves.
Huh. Kind of a on the road pour, and figure make a few of the mats, and then once I get home, I got a limited amount of time to use up the rest of it before it goes bad. So.
Huh.
I might as well.
How long does it have to set once it's in your mold there?
You got 4 minutes of working time to get it in the mold. Within 2 hours, it can be demolded and handled, used. 48 hours, it's full cure.
Okay. So you could actually pour one and then do another one tonight. You can do a couple of them.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. Do some more tomorrow.
Yep.
All right, well. That's okay, well, we're going to, I don't know when you plan on starting, but we're going to take a quick pause, and when we get ready to mix it up, we'll bring it back and we'll watch a pour. Right?
You bet.
All right. We'll be back in a minute. Looks like you're starting to get things ready. What, did you already spray down the mold?
Yeah.
And then?
I just got to let it sit for a little bit. Got these all cut up, ready to open them up. Might make a little bit of a mess.
Are you going to get the paper towel before you start, or?
They're right there.
All right.
Grab one little bit, just so I can wipe the lid.
You're not wearing your mask.
I got my gloves on.
Okay.
We're 6 feet apart. This doesn't look that way.
She's over messing with the cricket. Looks like you're a tattoo artist getting ready to tattoo somebody. Got your gloves on, you got your paper towels.
I'm getting ready to do some. I gotta go and figure out my amounts.
Those will make good buckets when you get done with them.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's a...
That's good.
And this is the what now? Liquid?
This is urethane rubber. Polyurethane rubber. So it's kind of clear up top.
Yeah.
You need to mix it before you do anything else. Mix them... Stir them separately because it settles. Some of the stuff will settle out.
Oh, yeah, I see like a color, discoloration in there, however you say it.
Yep.
Stirring the stuff up off the bottom.
This ain't gonna do any, it's not, doesn't hurt any, like make it set or anything like that. It's just getting everything mixed together. This stuff is a 1-to-1 mix ratio. However much of this I use, I have to use the same amount of the other.
All right.
To get the proper mix. I know roughly what I need to use. I'll just go ahead and mix up enough to make one. Since I got the small bucket.
This is basically like going to be your first production run, right? Or test
yep.
run?
Yep, this is the first production run. Limited run.
Got it on my vlog channel.
Yep.
New mat.
This is just the first design of many. I've got several other designs that I'm working on yet. This isn't the first time I've messed around with any of this stuff. So I've got a little bit of an idea of what I'm doing.
much you wanting to put in there?
I did my calculations earlier. To do one mat, I need 450 grams total between the two of them. So part B will be 225, and part A 225. And you always add the color into the part B. Both of these are pretty thin, but some of your other stuff, your part A will be a little thicker than the part B, or vice versa. A little goes a long way.
Oh, it does.
On the coloring. I barely put a little drop in there. The more you add, the darker it'll get. But you don't want to add more than, I think it's 10% of the total volume or total weight, because then it could cause cure inhibition.
Mm-hmm.
Darkened up.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a consistent. As long as you're consistent on the drops, your colors will stay consistent.
Oh, it looks good. Oh, yeah.
Yep, that looks like it'll come out looking pretty good. I'll put the lid back on this.
Timer.
Yep. Literally have 4 minutes to get it in a mold. Once they're mixed together. So I've only got about a minute and a half to get it poured mixed up once I combine them.
Clear.
Yep. And this stuff actually, if you don't put any color into it, this will, I think they said comes out a clear amber, see-through amber.
I don't think you have to.
This one should be all right.
Yeah, it's I don't see anything settled on the bottom of it.
You have to pour the other bag in.
Yeah, I'm going to. Better safe than sorry.
You have to pour some back.
Yes. Pour one into the other, and once I start, I'm gonna say go, and then I want you to hit the start on that.
Just tell me when.
See a difference.
Thirty seconds. You're at a minute. Oh, yeah.
while we wait. She'll start kicking here pretty soon.
Wow. And it sits for how long now?
2 hours from now, we can pull it out of the mat, out of the mold.
So just doing one, right?
Yep.
Okay. All right, so in 2 hours, we'll come back and you can pull it out, huh?
Yep.
Good job.
Thank you.
Well, when this gets cured, and if we can pull it out, we'll be back. 2 hours has passed.
Yeah.
Getting ready to show you what it now looks like.
Get a shot down here and show them that.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Just that little bit extra time. She's
wow.
A little bit tight.
That's a pretty yellow. Purple yellow. I'm looking at the mold, the yellow, it's a purple.
That is tacky.
Now, it fully cures at how long?
A full cure is 48 hours. So, handling time's 2 hours. So, I can demold it, take it out of the mold, and then leave it sit. And 48 hours later, it's ready to go and be used.
Gotcha.
Take a little bit to get them out. This will also help finish curing it too. Getting it out of the mold and letting the other side of it breathe. Do more of them, I'll use more of the mold release because it's sticking a little bit more than it should.
Right. You're talking about that spray?
Yeah.
Wow.
Just like that. And we got a little air bubble in there. That's all right.
I'm done.
Like I said, it's pretty floppy right now, but after 24, 48 hours, she should stiffen right up.
That is really cool.
From a 3D printer straight to a mold.
So you made
this
out of a 3D printer?
I designed the basically the 3D print was this.
Right.
And then I took that 3D print, made this mold, and now we've made the mat.
Hmm. Wow, that is really cool. Huh. That's awesome, Corey.
Thank you.
That is awesome. That is, I'll come over here and show you. And just used the basic, and now this is a urethane.
Yep.
It's a urethane mat.
Urethane rubber.
Urethane rubber. And this is made out of
silicone.
Silicone. So you got a silicone mold. And here is, well, you can see. how it hardens up, and it peels right out of there, don't it?
Oh, yeah.
Hmm. Anyway,
I hope you enjoyed this this video on how to make mats. Urethane mats, right?
Yep.
Urethane. That is really cool. Of course, my favorite color in a gold pen is purple, or matte is purple. And basically, you're just going to take, I'm going to make us three more of these and put it in a sluice, and we're ready to go prospecting.
Yeah.
So, that's awesome. Hope you enjoyed this little short segment on how to make gold mats, I guess you'd say. We'll have to get three more of these made, put it in a sluice, and do a video on how it catches gold.
Absolutely.
So anyway, until my next vlog that we have on my IGH Outdoors, I want to thank Corey for coming over and demonstrating on how to make these. It's really cool. Thank you, Corey.
You're welcome.
And until my next video, we'll see you later.